Hey guys, this is Greg with Medical Muscle. In this video, I'm going to talk about why I had to get rid of notes. I had to get rid of doing notes for lecture material. And I'm going to talk about why medical school is different and why you can't really do the same kind of study habits that you did in undergrad. Okay, so first off, there's a huge difference in volume. Okay, big difference. Medical school has a crazy amount of material in a very compressed amount of time. Okay, so each exam block, okay, you do a certain amount of weeks and then you have the exam at the end of that block, is 4 weeks, roughly, okay, somewhere around that time, all right? Each day you have, at St. George University, we had 2 50-minute lectures and 1 directed learning activity, which was like a half lecture that we had to do on our own. Now that does not seem like much, right? That's only 2 hours and then like a half lecture, right? But from talking with former students, SGU had compressed their lectures. Where it used to be 4 lectures, now it's compressed into 2. So in reality, the lectures are really double the content that would normally be covered. So I just remember one lecture, we had over 100 slides in a lecture. It was insane. There's just so much material, okay? So you have a lot of material. Now, how does this affect taking notes, right? Because notes make sense in undergrad, right? You're putting things in your own words. Makes sense. Why would it not work in medical school? As you're putting these, you know, the information into your own words, it takes time. It takes a lot of time. And because you have, you know, equivalent of like say 5 lectures, you know, split each lecture into 2, so that's 4, plus the DLA, that's 5. You have 5 days a week. That's a lot of information. You're gonna get behind very quickly, okay? Maybe the first week you can handle it because the lecture material is pretty light, but by the second week, you're gonna be behind on by Wednesday. That was my experience. So it's just, and it's a constant catch-up game, okay? That's the first reason why I don't think you should do it. It's just you're gonna be playing constant catch-up. The second reason is that you're spending a lot of time doing a really passive activity, right? You're just rewriting, you know, the information that you've seen. What if you really don't understand the material? You're rewriting something, but what was lectured and what you think is being presented is incorrect. What you can do instead is use alternative resources. This is huge. Using Pathoma, using Boards and Beyond, using Sketchy, using First Aid. Those resources can give you another way to look at the same information that maybe you didn't, it didn't click. Maybe you didn't realize that you had a gap in your knowledge. Maybe there's a piece of information that's missing. You know, those lectures are not complete. No one resource is complete. There's always gonna be missing pieces. And there's always gonna be someone who can explain something better. Sometimes the medical school's lecture is better than Boards and Beyond. That happens too, okay? So you really have to make sure you hit every resource because step 2 is gonna have almost anything, okay? So it's active, right? Or excuse me, it's not as active, right? Just to watch a video, but you're seeing more content. And then now that you've seen more content, you can do questions, okay? So the less time you spend writing notes, the more time you can spend doing something more active learning, like doing questions or discussing topics with a friend, you know, maybe on the end, at the end of the week, discussing all that you guys have gone over. That's more effective, I think. Okay. It's also mentally draining. I gotta say, I used to make all these notes. I put all this effort into it. It was so fatiguing. You know, just watching a video, a lecture video, is so like nice. You can sit back, listen to someone talk about it, and then you do questions. That's where you're really learning. Now, here's what I did. Here's what I did that I think worked, okay? Here's 2 different ways of making notes. I would say for basic sciences, I used Anki. You don't have to, but I found it very effective. The way I did it is if there was something that I felt like I needed to memorize that I was probably gonna forget within the 4 weeks, which if you write notes, okay, that's the other thing. You're probably gonna forget it. by the fourth week, you know, even if it's really good notes the first week, you're going to forget it by the fourth. Anki, okay, was my notes. I would just type stuff in and then make it into an Anki card. So I'm revisiting that material more actively. Okay. It's a lot of work. You got to put in all that information into Anki, or you can use someone's pre-made deck. That saves you some time. You're just doing Anki. Okay. It can say, actually, I feel like getting through maybe, you know, 150 cards would be faster than rewriting one lecture, maybe two lectures. Okay. Honestly. What I did during clinicals, which was really helpful because I didn't do notes then, was I took on my computer, I just made a note tab of just things that I needed to review or maybe just jot down things that needed to be memorized, okay? So tumor markers, those things are, you just have to memorize. You have to just know those, okay? Or different autoimmune markers. Those can be tough. That requires memorization. It helps just to put it down somewhere. So that is very helpful. But concepts are really not useful. You know, it's not very useful to write it down because when you do a question, it's going to mix not just that concept that you're writing down, but other concepts that you've covered during that block or maybe previous blocks. And now it meshes a question into multiple parts. And sometimes questions are hard more just because they're testing test-taking skills, okay? Sometimes they're putting a question out there that you can't answer from just straight lecture material. It takes critical thinking, okay? That's the next level, but that's usually later in your med school career, okay? What I did when I did do notes during term four is I tried to do a big Google document. Photos, I put quick notes, all this nice stuff. And I just felt like it was way too much work, way too much. Don't do that. Whiteboarding can be another good tool. I think whiteboarding is good. You know, it's a quick way to just help you memorize certain things that are tough to memorize, okay? But concepts, definitely get that through questions, get that through discussing it with other students, get it through looking at other resources to get other viewpoints of that specific topic, okay? All right, guys. If you haven't, please like and subscribe this video and stay tuned for more content.